to move a little further in our topic. Do you remember our topic? Yes, it was pressure. In the last class, we learned about pressure, how to calculate pressure, applications involving low pressure, high pressure, etc. But did you notice one thing? When I discussed about pressure, I discussed about the pressure exerted by solids. So in today's class, I'll be teaching you the topic pressure exerted by fluids. To begin with, what are fluids? Fluids are substances that has the ability to flow. Anything that has the ability to flow is known as fluid. So commonly, gases and liquids are termed as fluids. In today's class, I'll be dealing with the pressure exerted by liquids and the pressure exerted by gases separately. Let's move to the first part, pressure exerted by liquids. When you were very young, you might have made paper boats, right? And when you kept that paper boat on the surface of water, it floated. But imagine that you keep a few nails or some stones into that paper boat. What will happen? As you increase the weight of the boat, it sinks into the water. Have you ever wondered why? I'll tell you one more example. An empty plastic bottle. It floats on the surface of water. But if it is filled with water, it sinks into the water. A huge ship floats on the surface of water, even though it is made of iron. Liquids have a property to exert force on objects that are kept on the surface of liquids. That property is called buoyancy, and they exert a force which is called buoyant force. So whenever a body is kept on the surface of water, there is one force, the weight of the body, which is acting downwards. There is another force which is exerted upwards by the liquid, and that force is known as buoyant force. When the downward force is more, the object sinks in water. If it is less compared to the upward force exerted by the liquid, it floats on the surface of liquid. So what can we conclude? As the liquid exerts force, the liquid exerts pressure on the surface of water when objects are kept on there. Now I'm giving you an activity. Just take an empty used plastic bottle, cut its base and cover that base with a balloon as it is shown in the figure. Now let's fill water in this bottle. As you fill water in the bottle, what happens? Yes, you are right. The balloon bulges out. Why is it so? Because when water is filled into the bottle, that water exerts pressure at the base and the balloon bulges out. When it was an uncut bottle, the bottle with plastic base, the plastic is full, the pressure is not noticed. But when it is balloon, it expands and the effect of pressure at the base of the bottle is visible. What can we conclude? We can conclude that liquid exert pressure at the bottom of the container. If you fill more and more water, the bulging increases. Have you noticed it? So we may infer that the pressure exerted by the liquid at the bottom of the container increases as the height of water increases in the bottle. Now take another bottle and make a hole at one of its lateral side, a small hole. And if you fill water in the bottle, you see that the water comes out through the hole. I'm asking you to cover that hole with a balloon again. And as you fill water to the bottle, you can see that the balloon again bulges out. Why? When the balloon was attached to the bottom or the base of the bottle, it bulged out because of the pressure exerted by the liquid. So the same reason, the liquid exerts pressure on the sides of the container as well, so that the balloon bulges out. Let's continue with the activity. Now we made only one hole. I'm asking you to make more number of holes at different heights. And if you fill water in that bottle, you can see that the water comes out through the holes in such a way. See the manner in which water comes out through the holes. the speed with which water is leaking or the force with which the water is coming out of the holes is large from the holes at the bottom than compared to the holes at the top. Water coming out through the holes at the bottom is more than the force with which water is coming out from the holes which are at the top. Can you write your own conclusion now? Where will be the pressure more? The pressure is more towards the bottom. So if it is concluded in a single sentence, you may say that liquid pressure increases with depth. Liquid pressure increases with depth. As we go deep, the pressure is more, so that the water comes out from those holes with greater force. When we were very young, we used to draw water from the well. And when the bucket is used for a long time, there will be holes developed. And when we draw water from the well, water comes out through all these holes in such a way. Can you observe this picture and conclude something? At first, we cut the base of the bottle. We understood that pressure is exerted at the bottom of the container. Then we made a single hole at its lateral side and we said that the liquid exert pressure at the sides of the container. And we made holes at different heights and we analyzed the pressure exerted by liquid at different heights. So what will happen to the pressure if the holes are at same height? You can see so many holes at same heights and see how the water comes out through those holes. If you have a bottle, you can make holes at same height and observe it. Have you got conclusion? Liquid comes out of those holes which are at same height with the same speed, which means that the liquid exerts equal pressure at same height. At first we discussed about the paper boat and we understood that liquid exerts pressure on the objects kept on them. And then we took a bottle, we cut its base, we understood that liquids exert pressure at the base of the container. Then we made a hole on the lateral sides and we understood that the liquids exerts pressure at the walls of the container. And we analyzed that at different heights, the pressure is different. Pressure is more towards the bottom of the container. And at same height, the pressure is same. Altogether, we may conclude that liquids exert pressure in all directions. Liquids exert pressure in all directions. So, by doing all these activities, we got an idea about liquid pressure. And those information is used in various applications. I'll give you an example. The information regarding liquid pressure is used in the construction of dams. When we analyzed liquid pressure, we saw that the pressure increases with depth. So, when the dams are constructed, they are constructed in such a way that it is broad towards the bottom. It can withstand the higher pressure exerted by the water. I'll give you one more example. During blood transfusion, the bottle is hung at a higher position to enable the flow of the fluid. It was all about liquid pressure. Shall we move to the second part of this class? That is pressure exerted by gases. As we know, when a gas is taken in a container, the molecules of the gas exert pressure in all directions. Just like liquids, gases also exert pressure in all directions. To explain more about the pressure exerted by gases, let's discuss about atmospheric pressure. What is atmosphere? As you know, atmosphere is the gaseous envelope of air that surrounds the earth. Earth is spherical in shape and that sphere is surrounded by a gaseous envelope which we call as atmosphere. So what is atmospheric pressure? The pressure exerted by the gaseous envelope of the earth is known as atmospheric pressure. What is the cause of atmospheric pressure? Atmosphere, which is made up of gas, air, it has mass. It has weight so that it can exert force. The weight of the air is the reason for atmospheric pressure. In order to calculate the atmospheric pressure, how much is that? When I am standing here, on my head, I have particles of gases and the atmosphere extends up to many kilometers. And so that my head is holding the weight of the entire gases which is over my head. So imagine a cubical structure which extends up to several kilometers that carry that much of gases. It's a huge quantity. And the weight of those gases is exerted on the surface of my head. I'm supposed to get crushed, right? But I'm not. It's because of the blood pressure. We are created by the God Almighty in such a way that our blood pressure is opposing the pressure exerted by the gases, so that the effect of atmospheric pressure, which is acting downwards, is nullified. To get a better idea about the amount of atmospheric pressure, I'll give you three numbers. At sea level, the atmospheric pressure is measured to be 1 lakh pascal. As we go higher, when the altitude increases, the amount of gas or the density of gas is less. At around 5600 meters, atmospheric pressure is 50,000 pascal. If we move further high and if we reach altitude of 11 kilometers, the atmospheric pressure is measured to be around 25,000 pascal. So I think you got an idea how much is the atmospheric pressure and how it varies with height. Can you get me the value of atmospheric pressure around the satellites in space? In space, since we don't have atmosphere, since we don't have gaseous molecules, the atmospheric pressure around satellites is almost zero. Shall we move to the applications of atmospheric pressure? You might have used a straw to drink juices. When you used it, you suck in the air from the straw. And when the air is sucked in, a low pressure is created within the straw. And atmospheric pressure is acting on the juice. So atmospheric pressure is high, a low pressure region is created within the straw, so that from the high pressure region, that juice gets into the straw and you have it. Another example, you might have used rubber circle, a hook. You press the rubber hook and fix it on the wall. What happens when you press it? The air is evacuated, the air is removed, and you fix it on a wall so that inside the air circle, it's vacuum, almost vacuum, and outside the entire atmospheric pressure. So that push of the atmospheric pressure sticks it to the walls. Have you understood? So in today's class, we discussed about the pressure exerted by fluids. Liquids and gases are commonly termed as fluids, and that is why we divided the topic into two parts: pressure exerted by liquids, pressure exerted by gases. Pressure exerted by liquids. Liquids exert pressure in all directions. On the surface, at the bottom, on the sides. At the bottom, the pressure increases if the height of the liquid is more. At the sides, towards the bottom, pressure is more. Towards the top, pressure is less. And at same height, the pressure is same. Then gases. Just like liquids, gases also exert pressure in all directions. And we discussed about atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure is the pressure exerted by the gaseous envelope of the earth. Atmospheric pressure is applied in various daily life situations. You might have blown balloons. You might have filled air in the tube of your bicycle. Or you might have used a tube when you go for swimming. In all these cases, you make use of the pressure exerted by gas. I have some questions for you. Hope you understood my class. Two questions. Find out, why are deep divers given to wear special suit? Second question, how does a syringe work on the principle of pressure? Thank you guys. Hope you had a nice time. See you in the online class. Thank you.